Hello, in this video I will share the typical monitoring requirements for building electrical installations with photovoltaic self-consumption. And I will show digital architecture to achieve these requirements. Let's start with the monitoring functions typically required by energy or facility managers. First, to understand how the energy is used and how it can be optimized, you have to be able to do two related things. Track how the photovoltaic energy produced is used, consumed by the loads, stored or injected to the grid, and follow and analyze the trends of the photovoltaic production alongside the load's consumption. The following key performance indicators are commonly used: the self-consumption ratio, which represents how much of the energy produced is consumed by the loads, and the self-sufficiency ratio, which indicates how the photovoltaic production covers the building's energy needs. The monitoring system should also calculate the related economic benefits, because photovoltaic production reduces the energy consumed from the grid. Asset management features should also be provided by the monitoring system. In particular, it should assess the photovoltaic system performance, detect drifts or malfunctions, and notify about faults immediately. It should also monitor the inverters to make sure they are running properly and optimizing energy production. Photovoltaic inverters can also have an impact on the power quality of the electrical installation and are sensitive to poor power quality themselves. The monitoring system should therefore measure power quality disturbances, especially for harmonics and unbalance. I explained that in another video. Now, let's review the digital architecture that can meet these monitoring requirements. First, you need to collect input data such as photovoltaic production and inverter status from the photovoltaic inverters, power measurements, energy usage and power quality data from the power meters, and information on weather conditions such as temperature and irradiance provided by sensors. This data is then centralized using communication networks. The high-end power measurement devices and the photovoltaic inverters are usually connected directly through Ethernet. For sensors and other devices, gateways may be needed. For monitoring purpose only, the data acquisition frequency can be every 10 minutes on average. But when local control functions are required, the data should be collected more frequently. Examples of control functions are limiting photovoltaic production, managing power factor, and shifting loads, as I explained in another video. The data collected are then used by on-premise or cloud-based software for visualization, analysis, reporting, and for control if required. In addition, advanced cloud-based analytics allow to further optimize the usage of local electricity produced, taking into account complementary criteria such as changing electricity tariffs, weather forecast, and expected consumption. Optimized source configuration and set points are there transmitted to the local control system. In summary, to maximize the benefits of a photovoltaic system for self-consumption, you need to set up monitoring functions and track key performance indicators. You have now seen typical monitoring functions and the digital architecture needed to achieve them. Installations with photovoltaic self-consumption raise many technical questions on design, monitoring and control. Discover more in our other videos. Thank you for watching and see you soon!